top would be level with the ground. The reason we do that is so when we remove all these barrels and stuff, we can lay something over to cover it up. Nobody be able to see it. But for show purposes, we've got it raised up like that so you can see the pot and everything. This here's your cooking pot. This is groundhog itself. It's all it is just a big metal cooking pot. What we do is we come in here and find a good creek like this with good running water, good cool water, good high bank. We come in here, we bury this pot in the ground. This here's called a three-sack still. The reason it's called a three-sack is because back in the old days, sugar used to come in 100-pound sacks. So if they built a pot, it held three sacks of sugar, they called it a three-sack still. If it held four sacks of sugar, they called it a four-sack still, so on. But this one here happens to be a three-sack. And what we would do, we'd come in and put this pot in the ground. We'd put our sugar in there. We'd put 300 pounds of sugar, fill it up with water. We would add about 25 pounds of wheat bran and about a quarter of a pound of dry active yeast. Now what that's going to do, once you get you heat it up a little bit and get it lukewarm, get it up to about 80, 90 degrees, what's going to happen, you're going to start a fermentation process. That sugar and that yeast is going to start working with each other. It's going to start moving it in, rolling back and forth. That wheat bran, the reason that wheat bran is in there, so that when it starts working, that wheat bran will rise to the top because it's a real light material. And that wheat bran, once it rises to the top, it'll form a layer, like a cake, layer cake on top. The reason for that is so that while that stuff is working, it's building up heat. And you need to keep that heat inside that beer while it's working. Well, after about 3 days, after the working the fermentation process is over with, all that wheat bran is going to sink back to the bottom. When it sinks back to the bottom, it's going to clear off on top. And you're going to look at it, and when you look at it, it's clear, then you know it's time to do the distillery part of it. So at that point, what you have is you have 300 gallons of beer. You can actually drink it right out of the pot. But they call it still beer. But if you want to make moonshine with that, then what you got to do is you got to extract the alcohol out of that beer. And that's where the steaming process comes in. Once it's cleared off and you decide you want to make moonshine, you bring your barrels in. That's a 50-gallon oak barrel and one end of it has been taken out, so it slides right down in the hole of that pot. That's a steam pipe. It comes off of that and comes down into this double barrel. The reason you have that double barrel in is when you're cooking this, all you want is steam. You don't want any of the mash or anything getting, you just want the steam off of it. But if you was to have an accident and overheat it or something, some of the mash gets up in there, it can come through the pipe and drop over into this barrel. All your heavy materials will go to the bottom. Once it settles in the bottom, the steam will rise back off of it. And you have pure, clean steam coming down this pipe right here. Over here is what we call a car radiator worm. It's actually a car radiator that's been converted to a condenser. That steam will come through that pipe, and once it gets into that radiator, under that cool water, it's going to convert it back to a liquid. That steam is going to cool, and then it comes out as a liquid. This is where your moonshine comes out here. It'll come out that end right there. If we were actually making liquor down here, we would have that black barrel over here. It's called a proofing barrel. We would have it set up over here close to this worm. We would put a 5-gallon bucket under here. The first 5 gallons that run out of here is going to be around 170 to 75 proof. Well, that's a little bit too strong to drink. So what we would do, we'd pour that 5-gallon bucket into that barrel, into that proofing drum. We catch another 5 gallon, and as this thing runs, the alcohol content drops. The next bucket might be 140 proof. So we would take that, mix it with the 170, and blend it in. Well, the next bucket might be 120 proof. We would catch it, put it in the drum, and blend it in. What we would do is keep catching here and keep blending over here and testing this over here to get the desired proof we're looking for. If we want 100 proof, we just keep checking this barrel as we blend it. And if we had 105, then we know we need to add a little bit more of this to bring it on down. Once we get it to 100 proof, then the process is over with. You cut the gas off or fire whatever you're heating with, and then you jug your liquor up, your moonshine, jug it up and carry it out. After 2 or 3 hours, you can come back, take all these barrels down. It'll be cooled off enough by that time. Take all the barrels and the pipes away from it, then all you're left with is the pot in the ground. What you can do at that point in order to keep this thing going, is you get in there and use what we call a brand dipper. It's just a big dipper with holes in the bottom. You get in there and get all the old brand and stuff out of it, add a little bit more water to it, add your sugar and your yeast and your new brand. 3 days, you're ready to go again. So you can run this still about every 3 days. In the summertime, in the wintertime, it might take a day or two longer between the runs. Usually this still here, you can run it twice a week.
And how many gallons did you say you'd make?
It would average, this still here would average about 35 gallons. The first run won't turn out quite as much because everything is new, the water's fresh, you don't have any kind of alcohol or anything in it. So it's probably on the first run about 28 gallons. And then once you go back the second run to re-sweeten, you leave some of that juice that's in there. You don't take all that out, you just take the old mash out. You can add sugar to that, so you've already got a little bit of alcohol still left in that. And then the second run, you can get like maybe 32 to 35. And you can go three times before you have to take it down and completely clean it. The third run, you can get up to about 40, 45 gallons. But at that time, once that's done, then you need to take it completely apart, wash it up, clean it up, and start all over again. It's like using French fry grease. You get by two or three times by using the same grease, but after a while, it starts tasting kind of rancid. So it's the same way with us. Any questions?